those of you who just watched our Don't Buy a MacBook Just Yet video and decided to wait to buy a MacBook, congratulations because Apple has just released a couple of new MacBooks this morning. So in this video, we're gonna go through everything that's changed with these new MacBooks, and we'll also recommend which 2018 MacBook you should buy depending on your needs. For starters, Apple has quietly got rid of the $1,300 12-inch Retina MacBook and the old $999 MacBook Air, so their lineup is much more simple now. And this morning, Apple has released a new 13-inch MacBook Air with nothing but the addition of some display tech and a $100 price reduction to $1099, which is awesome news for users who need a budget MacBook. Apple has also finally updated the lower-end 13-inch MacBook Pro after 2 long years, bringing it from a dual-core processor to a quad-core, as well as bringing the Touch Bar a standard for the same $1,300 price. Now I've got to call this an incredible value. And if you're a student, you can pick one of these up for $100 cheaper and get a free pair of Beats headphones with Apple's back-to-school sale, which we'll link to down in the description. The only thing that's changed with the new MacBook Air is the addition of True Tone technology, which adjusts the white balance of the display to match your surroundings. I personally love this feature since it's easier on the eyes when you're in a warm lit room. The new low-end MacBook Pro released this morning gets True Tone as well, along with a bunch of other upgrades like getting the Touch Bar with Touch ID and getting Apple's T2 chip, which is great for security, video encoding, and automatic storage encryption. It's now packing a new 8th-gen quad-core processor, which is clocked lower than the old dual-core, but it'll definitely be a lot faster with hyper-threading and a pretty high turbo boost. It's also getting a bump up to Iris Plus 645 integrated graphics, which will perform somewhere in between the old 640 and the 655 graphics that comes in the $1,800 MacBook Pro. We'll be getting our hands on both of these new MacBooks soon, so if you want to see us test them, click subscribe right now so you don't miss out on those videos. Neither of them are packing Apple's rumored new Scissor keyboard. They're still packing the Butterfly keyboard, which should be updated with the new, more reliable materials like we saw on the high-end 2019 MacBook Pros. On the plus side, if you're still worried about the keyboard, Apple has added both new MacBooks to their keyboard repair program, so if you have any issues, Apple will fix them for free. We're still expecting Apple to announce the 16-inch MacBook Pro with the new Scissor keyboard later this year, maybe in September or October. So if you're looking to buy a high-end MacBook Pro, you should probably wait. But for everyone else who's been waiting for an update to the lower-end MacBooks, here's everything that's different between the new MacBook Air and the new MacBook Pro. The MacBook Air has 2 extra hours of battery life. The MacBook Pro will have much better processor and graphics performance. The Pro has a brighter 500 nit display and a much more color accurate display than the Air, with P3 wide color gamut. The Pro also has better speakers than the Air, and it comes with Bluetooth 5.0, while the Air sticks to 4.2. The Air gets the Hey Siri feature while the Pro doesn't, but I always turn it off anyway since I don't really care for it that much. The Air's keyboard is also sloped downward so you get a more comfortable typing experience, but the Pro has a larger trackpad, which I personally love. The Pro gets a much faster 61 watt charger compared to 30 watts on the Air, and of course, the Pro is $200 more expensive, which means you can get 256 gigs of storage on the Air for the same price as 128 on the MacBook Pro. However, the Pro is packing an incredible value this year, and we'd strongly recommend anyone who can afford the Pro to buy it over the Air. In fact, the $1,800 MacBook Pro is not that much better than the new low-end model. It just gets Hey Siri support, an extra 2 Thunderbolt 3 ports, slightly faster graphics, and faster quad-core processors. That's it. How much storage you choose is up to you, but we'd recommend at least 256 gigs if you love to deal with a lot of files or do work on your MacBook. And now that we have a more complete lineup of MacBooks this year, let's begin with our 2019 MacBook Buyer's Guide. If you just need a basic MacBook for doing things like using the internet, using web-based apps, doing basic school or business work, and streaming shows and movies on the internet, then the MacBook Air will be perfect for you. It gets more battery life, and you'll save a good amount of cash. And you'll probably be fine with 128 gigs of storage unless you really like storing photos and files. Now, if you need a bit more performance or you do entry-level professional work, then the new $1,300 MacBook Pro is for you. It packs a better and brighter display, which is great for things like photo editing. And now that it has a quad-core processor, faster graphics performance, and Apple's T2 chip, it can actually do basic 4K or HEVC codec video editing. The quad-core processor may be clocked at a lower 1.4 GHz compared to the $1,800 MacBook Pro's 2.4 GHz processor, but the turbo boost speeds are almost the same, so there may not actually be a massive difference between the two. And the extra processing power means you'll get more out of a powerful eGPU setup, which we'll definitely be testing soon, so make sure to subscribe now. Getting an eGPU means you may actually be able to do some high-end video editing and get a ton of extra gaming performance. So the new low-end 13-inch MacBook Pro is perfect for an eGPU setup. So now for the $1,800 MacBook Pro. Who should buy it? Well, if you're someone who really needs the extra processing power, like for higher end photo editing, using Logic, or coding, then you'll gain from the higher end 13-inch MacBook Pro. However, the biggest reason to upgrade to that model is for the extra two Thunderbolt 3 ports. If you know you'll need the extra ports, then you should definitely get that model instead. And it already comes with a 256GB SSD. So in reality, you're actually paying just $300 more for better performance. And finally, we have the 15-inch MacBook Pro. If you love large displays or you want a lot more performance with its standard 6-core i7 processor, a dedicated graphics chip, faster RAM, and more of it, then you should definitely buy the 15-inch MacBook Pro. This is great for video editors who don't want to buy an eGPU, or anyone else who wants some extra power for their professional work. It also comes with better speakers, a larger trackpad, and a faster charger. Now, if you want a very high-end MacBook Pro, like in the $3,000 range, we strongly recommend that you wait a couple of months for the 16-inch MacBook Pro announcement that we're all expecting. It's gonna be expensive, but we think it'll feature the long-awaited, full redesign of the MacBook Pro, with a new, better keyboard and a better display with thinner bezels. And it seems like that redesign could carry over into the rest of the MacBook lineup within the next year or two, where we may see the switch to Apple's new ARM processors. So there you have it, guys. If this video helped you make a buying decision, hit that like button and click the circle above to subscribe so you don't miss out when we get these new MacBooks in our office. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.